Weddings should be memorable, but not for the groom's lack of style. That's why our friends at the Black Tux rents suits and tuxedos that you'll love wearing at your wedding. So if you wind up getting featured on a list of 23 epic wedding fails, or say your reception table catching fire, your DJ playing Let's Get It On during the father-daughter dance, at least you know you'll look good for your close-up. Listen, guys stress about weddings too. Me, I've never been married, but I've had to rent quite a few bad tuxes in my day. Those rental stores, they're just renting you a penguin costume for the day. It's uncomfortable, it never looks right, and that giant bow tie, that's got to go. It's a big day. You got to have some style. So go to theblacktux.com. Check out their tuxes. Let me tell you, now you're dressing in style. They've even got a groom's guide with helpful tips for the groom who might be feeling a little overwhelmed by the whole getting married thing, if you know what I mean. But the best part about the Black Tux is that they have an easy online ordering process that brings your suit or tuxedo straight to you. Just pick a style at theblacktux.com and request a free home try-on so you can feel the fit and quality before you commit. And if online isn't your style, they have showrooms all over the country where you can find your fit and plan your look. From there, they'll ship your order 2 weeks before your wedding so you can check it out one last time. Talk about commitment. Over 5,000 five-star reviews across Wedding Wire, The Knot, and their own website. They all agree you won't find another rental experience or designs like the ones you'll find at The Black Tux. Grooms, if you want your wedding to be remembered for the right reasons, visit theblacktux.com/listen. That's theblacktux.com/listen for $20 off your purchase. Walk, don't run to theblacktux.com/listen to find a look for you and your crew. Theblacktux.com, formal wear for the moment. It's the E-Commerce Minute, your daily dose of e-commerce, tech, and retail news with your hosts, Bart Meraz and John Suter. The E-Commerce Minute is a production of Sumo Heavy, a digital commerce consulting firm in Brooklyn, New York, and Philadelphia. Find us on the web at sumoheavy.com. It's E-Commerce Minute episode 365.
In today's episode, Alibaba made smart screen to help blind people shop.
Up to 190 million people in the world experience significant difficulties with disabilities. That portion of the world's population could get left behind in technology without proper solutions. Fortunately, global marketplace giant Alibaba and Damo Academy have partnered to make interacting with technology much easier for both physically and visually impaired individuals. Smart Touch is a smart screen that was developed by Alibaba and Damo Academy to assist visually and physically disabled individuals with mobile device tasks, specifically shopping tasks. The Smart Touch technology uses a thin, clear film with three discrete braille buttons that are specifically programmed with certain common commands like confirm or go back. The main goal is to ease the process of purchasing products online by reducing the likelihood that users will accidentally confirm or delete data. The Smart Touch film creators also intend to create a very affordable product as the film's cost is only 3.6 cents each to produce. The Smart Touch technology also makes use of other sensors to help visually or physically impaired mobile device users. The Alibaba and Damo Academy developed product uses audible cues and technology to help consumers navigate their devices. For example, Smart Touch allows users to discreetly listen to instructions by holding the phone up to their ears instead of utilizing the sometimes intrusive speaker function on their mobile device. While the Smart Touch technology will only be available on select Alibaba apps for the time being, like Taibo and Alipay, the company has plans to expand the technology to other apps and platforms. Remarkably, the Smart Touch film has the ability to take different functions depending on which app is open on the mobile device. Perhaps even more remarkable is the R&D duo of Damo Academy and Alibaba do not plan to monetize the Smart Touch technology. Ideally, they'd like to distribute the haptic films through Alibaba's network of stores in various communities throughout China. The Smart Touch haptic film accessibility technology is slated to roll out in early 2019. I like this one.
Yeah, I mean, that solves a lot of problems, right? I mean, we're always faced with problems with e-readers or not e-readers, the readers for blind and things like that.
Yeah, accessibility has always been a big problem in technology. It's come a long way. I'm impressed with what a simple solution this really is. If you look, we'll have a picture on our website, ecommerceminute.co, which shows the film that is attached to the phone. It's basically they get around a whole giant problem with just a 3 cent piece of film that has commands that, and I guess you could just map commands to the piece of film, and which will give the haptic feedback that the user needs. It's really neat.
Oh, that's really, that's definitely really, really fun. I mean, if that's the, you know, that's the solution, that's the easiest, right?
Yeah. And, you know, and there's audible cues too, because a lot of the assistive technologies for blind people obviously use audio cues. And the one thing that the article pointed out was some of those are a bit obtrusive. So they've kind of tailored that so that they can hear the commands, but you know, if they're sitting on a bus or sitting in a public place or just sitting somewhere where there's a lot of people, they can discreetly listen to the audible commands and go shopping, which is great.
No, it definitely is. I mean, it opens up the world, right? But a simple solution like this, this is great.
Yeah, I think this is a really great story. It'd be neat to see this roll out and more importantly, come to the U.S. Doesn't seem like there's any plans right now to keep looks like they want to keep it in the Alibaba ecosystem, but it's commendable that they don't plan to monetize it. And, you know, it's obvious why they're doing that. It's not completely altruistic. It's let's get this to become a common standard that we're known for. And where are they going to use this technology on our websites and apps? So, you know, it's, while it sounds completely altruistic, it's not 100%, but still.
No, still very, it still gives you a little more access than the usual.
Sure, sure. And it's still a commendable thing. And I like technology being used in a smart, helpful way like this. So it's a great story. All right. Got anything else to add?
Nope, that's it.
All right. You can find full show notes at ecommerceminute.co. That's your e-commerce minute for today. We'll see you on the internet tomorrow. That's it for today's show. If you like the show, do us a favor and subscribe or leave us a review on iTunes. And don't forget, you can now listen to the e-commerce minute on your Amazon device. Just add e-commerce minute to your flash briefing. And finally, if you have a comment or suggestion or just want to say hi, find us on social media at Sumo Heavy.